When building your interfaces and reports, it's important to display the latest available data so that users can make informed business decisions. To keep your data up to date, you can configure the refresh behavior in your interfaces. Before we start, if you haven't watched the previous video on local variables, be sure to check it out first before continuing. As a recap, you'll learn that local variables that are used within interfaces can refresh their values under a variety of conditions. When a variable is refreshed, the value of that variable is recalculated and the variable is updated with the latest value. By default, all variables defined within the local variables function refresh when any referenced variables change. In this video, we'll learn how to modify this default behavior by using the abang refreshVariable function. This function is very versatile and will allow you to refresh values in a number of scenarios. Simply make sure to define the refresh behavior by picking the right parameters. Let's go over the options. The first scenario is when you want to disable the default refresh behavior. If you need to make a copy of a variable for later comparison, or if you don't want something to be calculated each time a referenced variable changes, you can set the parameter refresh on referenced var change to false. To configure this behavior, you'll first need the refresh variables function. The first parameter, value, is the value of the local variable when it's created. When a user first opens the interface, both fields will display the logged in user's first and last name. The following parameter is the desired refresh behavior, in this case, refresh on referenced var change. Since the parameter is set to false, the user can change the preferred name field without changing the full name field. Another scenario is when you want to refresh a local variable based on when a specific variable not referenced in the variable's value changes. Here, the parameter refresh on var change makes it so that the local variable, username edited timestamp, refreshes every time the username value changes. Without it, the timestamp would just display the current date and time when the interface first loads. If you need a variable to refresh automatically based on a timer, you can use the refresh interval parameter. This is helpful for keeping information on a dashboard or task report up to date. In this example, the milestone is set to refresh every 30 seconds or whenever the refresh counter changes. If you replace 0.5 with 2, the milestone status will change to refresh every 2 minutes. As you can see in this expression, you can choose to combine multiple refresh configuration parameters to increase the refresh frequency. Instead of a timer, you can also trigger refreshes based on user interactions. When set to true, the refresh always parameter will refresh the value of the local variable whenever a user interacts with any of the interface components. When a variable is using the refresh always configuration, the variable will refresh on every evaluation, regardless of whether its dependencies change. Lastly, you can configure your variables to refresh after a record action dialog is submitted. With the refresh after parameter, you can update a local variable in the interface to reflect the changes that resulted after a record action completes, without refreshing the entire interface. In this interface, the refresh after parameter is configured to update local bang vehicle data after a user completes the update vehicle action. In all of these scenarios, the refresh variable function was used to configure various refresh behaviors. For charts and read-only grids, know that you can easily configure the same refresh behaviors using the available options in the component configuration pane. The options you select will automatically apply to any data used to populate the grid or chart. Let's recap. Abang refresh variable allows you to modify the default refresh behaviors of local variables. This function gives you control over what you want to use to trigger an update, whether it's a referenced variable, specific variable, user interaction, timer, or record action. To learn more about this function, visit Appian documentation. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.